Hello everyone and welcome to VLAN Tech Corner. In this video, let's take a look at the XPON ONU Stick from HSGQ. After that, I will walk you through the GPON ONU's web interface. At the end, we will replace the ISP provided ONT, the Dyson H646GMV with this HSGQ SFP module and have a quick speed test. In the market, the ODI DFP-34G-2C2 and the DFP-34X-2C2s are very popular and well known. The XFP modules have SC-UPC connector and is powered by the Realtek RTL9601D chip. There's something you may yet to know. ODI is actually a brand from HSGQ, and newer versions of the GPON stick come with HSGQ name instead of ODI. That is why the XPON sticks on this video had the same form factor with those ODI XFPs, except for the SC-APC fiber connector. Yes, it is also powered by the Realtek RTL9601D2. The HSGQ GPON stick can be configured as an XFU, single family unit, or HGU, home gateway unit. As an XFU, it will be more or less a bridge converting fiber signal to Ethernet signal. For HGU, the device can act as a router where it handles NAT and PPPoE connection. For this video, I will use the device in XFU mode. To get started, we will need a media converter if your router doesn't have an XFP port. Here, I have a 2.5G media converter. The XFP module is connected to the media converter via the XFP cage, and the Ethernet port of the media converter is connected to my PC. Let's go to the PC and begin the configuration. So let's go to the network connection right here. Go to the network adapter, right click properties, and then let's go to TCP IPv4. The XFP is available at 192.168.1.1, so we need to set our IP address to something in the same subnet. So I will put 192.168.1.5 for example. Hit OK and then OK. So make sure that the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0 or slash 24. Now let's open command prompt and try to ping 192.168.1.1. And very good, we have the response. So now I'm going to open a web browser. So let's say we are going to visit 192.168.1.1 and hit enter. So for some reasons, I don't need to log in, but if this is your first time access the XFP module, you will need to log in with the username is admin and the password is admin. So after login, we can see that the logo is actually ODI, where the device is HSGQ XPON Stick. Actually, ODI is a brand or a chill companies of HSGQ. That's why you will see sometimes it is ODI, sometimes it is HSGQ. Alright, so this is the current firmware. We have the CPU load, the memory uses, and the IP address for our LAN or for the XFP module itself. And next we have the PON tab. So right here we can see the PON status, temperatures, voltage, TX powers and RX power. So usually when the GPON module is not configured, the TX will have no signal at all. And because it is not configured, the GPON status is O2 and we see an error message LOID error. So even though my ISP or my ONU doesn't use LOID to authenticate, but it still say LOID error. So that's why you shouldn't get confused with this error message. So next we have the LAN tab. So basically just the IP address for the XMP. We have settings. So right here we can change mode of the GPON parameters such as the LOID, LOID password. For the POEM password, we can configure whether it is ASCII or hex. So if hex you have 20 characters and if ASCII you have 10. So right here we have the POEM password. And next we have the GPON serial number. So after we do this one, we can press apply, and basically this is the main information. So if this is your first time getting started with XRP GPON module, you need to start with this information. And if the XRP doesn't work, if the GPON is not authenticated, then you will proceed to change the vendor ID, shareware version, and then product class and hardware version and things like that. And then we have the OLU. So usually the OLU will be the first 6 characters of the MAC address of the device. And after that, we have the device serial number. So please don't get yourself confused between the GPON serial numbers and the device serial number. So this device serial number will be something the ISP will use this one to track the router's access. And usually at the back, you will see both the device serial numbers and the GPON serial number. So next we have the MAC and the MAC key. In order to change the MAC address, you will need to change the MAC key as well. So it is a little bit confused. So you will need to know the structures, and in order to have the MAC key, you will need to create an MD5 hash of this string. So it will be HSGQ1.9A followed by the MAC address in capital. Alright, so after that, you will need to put it here. So after you done all the thing, you can press apply change and it will apply. Alright, so next we have the VLAN settings and it requests me to log in. Okay, I'm fine. So I think it's will time out. So let's log back in, admin and admin. So VLAN settings, we can change the VLAN setting to auto or to manual VLAN. And when we turn on the manual VLAN, we can select transparent mode or PVID, which is attack VLAN right here. Next, let's see, we have commit reboot, we have reboot timer, we have backup restore, and password for the admin, firmware upgrade and logout. So basically very basic UI. And actually I do have a video for the Hisense before this, and more or less we can see that the configuration and the option is the same. Now let's go ahead and configure the PON in order to get an O5 status. So let's go to the setting right here. And if you remember this one, some time ago I have a video for the LEOX LXT-010S-H. And actually we will use the same fiber line to configure it. So let's start with the GPON serial number. So where is it? This one is the GPON serial number. And for POEM password, we don't need it. So first of all, let's save and apply first. So let's go to PON and refresh. So it's still 02. So let's go and reboot. Okay. So meanwhile, I will open command prompt and try to ping the device to see when it is up and running. Very well, we have the response from the XFP module. So let's go back to the web UI and refresh the page. Okay, let's log in and then let's see. Let's go to the PON and we have an O5 status. So we can see that the configuration for my SP is very straightforward. So basically, we just need a GPON serial number to get authenticated. So very good. Now if I'm going to connect the meta converter to my NanoPi R6S, and we will see if they are working internet connection. So right now the R6S is connected to my PC, and the one port of the R6S is connected to the meta converter. Let's open the new tabs on the PC and go to 192.168.2.1 to access the LUCIs of the R6S. So let's go to network and interfaces as usual. So right here I have set up an IPv4 interface of 192.168.1.3 to reach the XFP. So let's go to the device again, because this time we will need to check something related to the VLAN. So let's log back in and then let's go to the VLAN setting. So the PON, we know that it is 05. So on the VLAN setting, it is auto VLAN. So now I don't know which VLAN is available, and usually my ISP run their PPPoE connection on VLAN 35, so I will need to set up the interface on this VLAN first. So let's go to the one. So right here you see that the one port is Ethernet 2. So let's go and edit this PPPoE connection. Click edit, and the device, let's see right here, we don't have interface 35, so I will need to create a new VLAN. So let's put it Ethernet 2 dot followed by the VLAN and hit enter. So let's make input the PPPoE connection password. Alright, so I have just filled in the PPPoE connection username and password. So let's click save and then save and apply. So hopefully the internet connection will be up, but let's wait for it. Alright then, error message, unknown error, user request, but we do see some TX and RX. So, what could be wrong? Let's wait for it. So we see a lot of package going on. Alright, and finally, the interface or the connection become off, and we have an IPv4 and IPv6 from the internet service provider. So the connection is off as well. So let's have a quick speed test. Let's go. So very good. We are having 2000 Mbps download. And this is more or less the same with the LEOX LXT-010S-H that I have tested previously. So that's worth a fast download speed. However, the upload speed is quite slow, so I'm not sure if this is something related to the XRP or it is something related to the connection. So let's go and test with another server, and this time we will see the truth. So testing with FPT, we can see that the downloads reach 1054 Mbps, but the upload is still low. I will change to another server and let's verify. So unfortunately, we have a very low upload speed at this time. So perhaps I will try another time and then I will confirm with you whether I have a better upload speed. But right now you can see that it is 10:30 PM and it's a peak hour where a lot of people trying to access the internet, and my plan is an uncommit plan. So theoretically I should get around 300 Mbps, but just now I get up to 2000. So I think let's wait for another time and we'll verify if the XRP can handle around 1000 Mbps upload. Before ending the video, let's go back to the HSGQ XRP web interface. And right here, you can see that the VLAN settings are on auto. However, you can create a manual transparent mode or you can tag your VLAN right here. So let's say right now, my PPPoE connections were set up on VLAN 35, and if your router for some reason doesn't support VLAN tagging, then you can set the VLAN 35 right here. And after that, you just need to set up your PPPoE connections on the interface with just a normal Ethernet 2 without the VLAN. And for this one, as I already mentioned, if you don't get an OFI, which means successfully authenticate status, when changing the GPON server number, you need to clone all the other parameters such as vendor ID, shareware version, hardware version, and things like that. So that will be all for this video. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.